I took 2 days off work. I wasn't feeling too well. That's why the last two videos you saw were done in my house and with bad light. So I'm back here where my face has to shine. Light is actually very okay. So welcome to today's recap of Big Brother Naija. We're going to be talking about day 8 in the Big Brother Naija house. Started with exercises, you know, normal routine in the BBA house. Do you want that one is so lazy. But they behave like this with their belly. You never seem to do anything. You just go there, just sit down. I really hope that the next task they give them is based on physical work. I need to see what that guy. Even did you watch the head of us challenge? It was just like this. I think he just can't do anything with his life, only to gossip. Okay, so how did it start? Significant events that happened. Anika was outside talking to Bam Bam. I was just teasing Bam Bam, like, Bam Bam, I know you like Teddy. And Bam Bam was just blushing. Once she just hears Teddy, baby girl is just blushing and everything. You know? And she blushed. Then what else? While they were talking, Teddy came outside. You know, when Bam Bam was even trying to reply, Anika, she was like, you know, in this house, 45, they don't, you know, I don't like celebrities, and Teddy sings. Maybe afterwards, after this house. And Anika was like, excuse me, calm down. What do you mean afterwards? You know, Teddy came and, you know, disrupted. I think he just came to check up on his babe. They're actually very close now. They play, you know, that kind of rough play couples play with each other where they have themselves. So Teddy will say, you can bring this jaw. Teddy is always helping Bam Bam. Like, Teddy, can I have water? Teddy will bring water. Teddy, I want food. Teddy will bring food. And Teddy, we're going to drop this plate. You know, they're so comfortable with each other right now. If you ask me, I actually think Teddy likes Bam Bam already. He's just trying to be that bad, self-acclaimed bad man, trying to hide it. But I think he's always with her, even though he tries to mingle with other housemates. But after a while, he's going to check up on Bam Bam. Then D1 and Vandora, those ones, they are everywhere. You see, D1 is a gossip. We all know that. Even when I like gossip, I like gist. But you know, I think in the course of liking gossip and gist, you should have like one or two persons you're loyal to that you probably would not go around discussing them. D1 has nobody. D1 goes to everybody talking about them. Like if he goes to Ifu, he's talking. He just doesn't have anyone he's loyal to. He talks and tries to, you know, I think he just tries to remove himself. You know, he tries to be so close so they don't nominate him. He's just a bloody silly gossip. Very a bad sight for a man. Vandora, so that one is always gossiping. Then there was a point Bam Bam was in the room. The next day, Beto just went to meet Bam Bam. Bam Bam, can you imagine? Vandora was trying to seduce your man. She was trying to seduce Teddy. Vandora knows you're with Teddy. So why would she seduce Teddy? I like the response Bam Bam gave to, what's it called? To Beto. Bam Bam was like, well, in this house, 45 days. So people would do what they would naturally do to, you know, help themselves in this game. Then Sissy and Toby, of course, you know, they quarreled the previous night. They still had their little sort of, but somehow they were able to squash it. Toby apologized again, like, dude, apologized again in the morning. Sissy looked happy, they talked about it. Sissy was like, I beg, fuck whatever Ibuka says. Nobody can just come and say we should do this. We're going to know. They came back together, actually. They're just basically saying, we're back together and there's no big deal about it. Bit of fun in the house. Vandora, Ifo, Anto trying to give D1 a lap dance. It was just, you know, so just a playful session with Princess shouting. That girl is just a noisemaker. She's always shouting, oh yeah, fuck Big Brother. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, what the fuck? Oh, shit. Oh, Big. I don't know where she's acquired the English from. That sounds like Abba Chinese. Oh, what the fuck? What the fuck? I went to Manhattan. When I got to Manhattan, my friends are strippers. You know, she wants her voice overshadowing everybody's voice. She's just a certified noisemaker. You know, you saw people conspiring about vote, you know, about what's it called? Nomination. You're allowed to conspire with your partners concerning nomination. So people conspired and, you know, different pairs talking about who they would want to nominate at every time. Now, time for, of course, nomination fever setting. People were sleeping. We didn't know how. We just discussed nominations and everything. And there was a time Lulu and Anto sat down and we were saying that they believe Toby and Sissy won't be able to put them up. blah 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 blah. You know, they just talked about different things. So time for nomination. My brother told them to get ready for their nominations, come out to the gardens, get the representative to come into the diary room to nominate two pairs each. And it started. Lotto, which is Lulu and Anto, came in. It was Anto who represented the pair, and she nominated Angel Ifu, that is Angel and Ifu Inada, and K-Square, Chloe and Kepele. CB, which is Toby and Sisi. Toby came in to represent the pair and nominated Brito and Princess Brito, and Lotto and Anto, Lulu and Anto. Bam Teddy, which is their name in the house, even though I prefer to call them Badi or Bam Teddy Bam. Bam Teddy came in and nominated K-Square, Chloe and Kibuli, and Mina, Miracle and Nina. Angel Ifo, represented by Ifo Inada, came in and nominated K-Square, which is Chloe and Kibuli, and Alex and Leo, Leolex. Preto, represented by Bito, nominated K-Square, nominated Bam Teddy, that's Bam Bam and Teddy A, and Chloe and Kipuli K-Square. Renika, represented by Anika, nominated Mina and Preto. Leolex, represented by Leo, nominated Angel Ifo and Preto. K-Square, represented by Chloe, nominated Mina and Preto. Mina, represented by Miracle, nominated K-Square and Angel Ifo. Van D, represented by Vandora, nominated Angel Ifo and Lotto. So big afterwards, they went inside the room, inside the house, inside the lounge rather. Big Brother announced those up for nominations: Lotto, Angel Ifo, Mina, Preto, K-Square, and told Toby to exercise his veto power, which is save someone and replace. If you do not do that, you have to put up for possible eviction. Toby didn't waste time. I like that. You know, he didn't waste time. He saved Mina and replaced with Bam Teddy. And that was it. You get to see Teddy's face. You know, he has a special expression, like you could see he wasn't having it. You know, afterwards the house just looked scattered, and it was now time for diary sessions. Rico went in first. You know, he said whatever he had to say. He was happy they were not nominated. And Rico said there's now this rivality, in his words, there's now this rivality between Toby and Teddy. Princess came in, I was like, you know, she came to diary, I don't know, Big Brother, I'm nominated, I'm not happy. I was, you know, it shows I'm a strong person, I'm a strong character, that's why I got nominated. And she said she felt like the housemate nominated her because she's a slave queen that cooks. And I'm like, okay, Paso, what's wrong? What are you saying? What do you mean? You're a slave queen that cooks? That girl doesn't know she's annoying. Like, she's really, really, really annoying. Then Toby said she's a strong contender. And that's the reason, you know, it feels like a strong contender. And the reason why he put Bam Teddy was because it feels, it's just strategic. It feels they're strong contenders. It saved Mina because it feels like the housemates, especially the ladies, do not like Mina. And you know that immediately after he did that, Teddy came to meet him with some words, like some war words, like the battle line has been drawn. Sisi came, she said she's so excited, she's happy, you know. That she would want the viewers to save Bam Teddy. She likes them. She likes Bam Teddy. She would just want the viewers to save Bam Teddy. Mina came into the room. I was like, ah, thank you. That she's so grateful. That I just feel like it is God who did this. You know, God knows the heart of a king. That she's happy. She doesn't even understand how or why Toby saved them. She feels like most people in the house nominated her, especially Princess, that there's this jealousy about Princess. Whenever Princess sees her sitting down with Miracle, you know, and she's actually grateful to the head of house for saving them. If Renata came, I know she was just hyper, they nominated me. You know, prior to that time, Angel already told if Renata that, you know, don't worry, that nobody's going to nominate us because I don't even, I think I'm going to stay in this house for long without people noticing and nominating us. So it was a rude shock to them. Angel was shocked. You know, he went under the radar immediately for the nomination. So if another came and she was like, you know, people, they nominated me. I don't know why they nominated me. I actually heard that they nominated me because I split or I do my workouts. I don't give a fuck about it. People go fuck themselves. When Big Brother asked her what she felt about Toby's decision, she was like, wow, Big Brother, that head of us is a fool. Toby's a fool. Like, why would Toby replace Mina and Nina with Bam Teddy? She just felt like Toby should let go of the weaker characters. You know, now what happened was majority of, let's say 70% of people who came into the diary session said they're surprised with Mina and Nina. They're not surprised Mina and Nina got nominated because they actually consider them the weaker links or the weaklings in the game. Leo came, I was like, he's happy that Mina got saved because most people do not like Nina. Who else? Beto came into the diary room. I just want to release the volume of my TV. And he just came, a Big Brother, I was nominated. It's blah, 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 blah. Then the next thing, all through in the last 3 days, he's been talking about Cleo shoving him, Cleo pushing him, and he could have just gone to report to Big Brother. I could have gone to report, but I didn't want to report. Finally, he got his pound of flesh, he reported. He now told Big Brother that some days ago, Cleo pushed him. Cleo was upset that he didn't give Cleo his ice cream tub, he gave it to Princess. Cleo pushed him. Then Kebrule is not normal. Kebrule attempted suicide 3 times. He cut his, and I'm like, wow, Beto. You know the thing about Beto?
It's interesting. Beto certain subjects and areas of
the
life.
Power of the diary room.
And if I have certain word cycles and on my team, I just might crash that boat too. So that's why I decided to put these two people who virtually have shown the house that they don't have control of this stuff. If mine was looking like I lost control of it and I can actually convince my teenager that, hey, that was an accident, I'm cool. And they can see the connection. After all, I'm not so dumb, I want to pay for this. So that's why I put them up.
Kebule is suicidal, it shouldn't be in this house. If someone like Bam Teddy, I hate the way Teddy talks to Bam Bam. Bam Bam is a good girl, but I think Teddy's not a gentleman to Bam Bam. Later he contradicted himself and he said Bam Bam and Teddy, they're very talented. So maybe outside the house, I could do something with them, but not inside the house. Mina and Nina, I'm happy to be seeing Mina and Nina because they are weak. So you know, they'll never win me in diary room. They'll never win me in head of house task. You know, it was just ranting. And it was just being stupid, as usual. That is who Beto is. Then finally, it was time for Teddy to come in, and Teddy came in, balance, crossed his leg. You know, before he came in, like, you guys know I like Teddy. I always say I don't think he's my favorite housemate, but I have this thing. I like him, so I'm drawn to him. So I see myself most times, you know, talking about him a lot. Before Teddy got into the diary room, I already told myself this one is going to he's going to say something Nigerians, he's going to act the way Nigerians do. Like, you know, Nigerians, they like very humble people. In their words, they call it humbleness. You have to have humbleness in Nigerian world. You have to have humbleness. You know, they like, so I was expecting Teddy to misbehave this week because last week, told Big Brother, last week was just coming to observe and this week he's going to bring out his bad man character and everything. But I was just, Bam Bam answered that question very well. Bam Bam was so mature when she was answering that question. And Teddy came in, she was upset. He said, Big Brother, I was having a good day till someone decided to put me up. That you see, I like to believe I'm the strongest contender in this house. And Toby knows I'm the strongest contender. That's why he put me up. But you know, if that is going to talk about their parents, that for him it's obvious that Bam Bam likes him and he likes Bam Bam. You know, they enjoy each other's company, they are fluid with each other, unlike Sissy and Toby. He said Sissy is just with Toby because Sissy just wants to use Toby for some privileges, certain privileges like head of house. So it feels like he has Bam Teddy have this strength or edge against CB. So of course everybody knows that, Toby knows that, he would have done what Toby did by putting the strongest competitor up, but it would not have saved Mina. That Mina and, what's it called? Mina and, that's Miracle and Nina, which is Mina, are the weaklings in this house. So it would have taught Toby would, leave Mina and Lina in the group so they can be a level playing field, you know, have some allies and let those who are strong battle it out together and trust and everywhere scatter. I don't want you to say you're the strongest contender. His confidence is 100. He's cocky, which I don't think should be a surprise. Seeing him, you sit there, you know that that is what he is. Well, I don't know how that is going to play out. If you ask me, I think I want Eddie up every week. I want him to battle for that spot. Let him, you know, I want him to just feel the heat. That's what, if you ask me. Everything that happened yesterday, I was totally in support. I wanted Toby, you know, Toby won. I didn't tell you guys, sorry. Toby won the head of house. Even though, if you ask me, I felt like it wasn't transparent enough. That's the head of house thingy. So people had issues with their helmets. So he had an advantage. He won the head of house. And he chose Sissy to spend time with him in the luxury room. And everybody didn't find that funny. They were not happy about it. Most housemates were upset. They said it wasn't transparent enough. Toby could see. Other was like, Lulu was like, why should Toby choose Sissy? She should have taken someone else into the house, into the luxury room and everything. So that's why Toby had the power to save. I wanted Toby to win out of house. I don't care if Toby's put up. I didn't care if Toby put up on Bam Teddy. But for strategy's sake, I was hoping Toby would have been more strategic, you know. I don't think you should show your hand early in the game. For instance, look at Effie. Every time Effie went into that diary session, into that diary room to nominate Tibos, he would never ever have swapped Tibos. He would never swap Tibos. You know, sometimes when you want to attack your enemy, this is for Toby now, don't let them see you coming. Just go and do the dirty work in the diary room and come out and ask everything. But right now, the battle line is drawn. Toby knows that he's now a target with the house needs. So let him just keep winning this head of house task because they are waiting for him. You know, they are seriously waiting for him. All of a sudden, Teddy became very noisy. You know, just talking, the people who got nominated went to sit in one corner drinking, Princess shouting, I'm real, they nominated me, they're blah, 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 blah. No, they're just talking. You know, Bam Bam was worried. Teddy went to me and was like, babe, do not be worried, you're not going anywhere, just calm down, don't be worried. Nomination blues started now. And they started Big Brother Nigeria Church. Angel, before then, Angel was talking to Ifun and said he's worried, you know, there's some things not going true or going well for him in his life. He's worried, he picked up his guitar and he started playing. Ifun was with him, Bito was with him, Anika was with him, they were singing worship songs. Bam Bam was ready on the bed, maybe she heard worship song. Bam Bam remembered God yesterday. Bam Bam came to the bed, they're singing, lovely voice. It was an amazing worship session. I was in my house and I was worshiping with them, you know. But they all remembered God yesterday, you know, the nomination news came. The nomination news set to like, they all remembered there was God and, you know, everything happened like that. They showed the housemates waiting, getting ready for bed. Bam Bam. After worshiping God, baby girl to set a match close to our home. And she was just giving all this. I know the size, and anyway, for my fellow women watching, and if you don't tell the man that you wanted to do anything, and you know those signs you give him, just start touching him. The next thing I had was on Ted, this thing, lips was here, she was looking up. You know, kind of, I look and the man just turns and gives me this kiss, like, oh, my guy just stay, my guy just maintaining level. Teddy, that Ted is wicked. That guy is so wicked. Like, the girl gave him every sign. She was always giggling. She would hug him and everything. The guy did not even, just smiling. Just his hand, just, you know, his hand was, of course, here. The other hand was just there. He didn't even move, not even a peg. The guy just maintained the level. You know, she tried everything. So, for someone that was like miracle. I wish she did find a stage for get her. But you know, that was it. K. Brilliant and Chloe. I don't know what's going on, no. That foolish cameraman. See, if you guys know, even though you don't want to show us what's going on in this Big Brother house, when it's 7 o'clock, off your TV, how can we be awake and you're not showing us? The next thing we saw K. Brilliant and then Chloe, they were looking. Initially, they were looking to see if people were awake. Then Teddy saw them. Then Teddy was trying to keep quiet. Then he laughed. Then what's his name? Chloe was like, Teddy, what's your problem and everything? Then Teddy closed his eyes. The next thing, they looked and they went under the duvet. What were they under the duvet? I don't know. But you know the duvet and the window. The next thing, camera went off. Went to Miracle and Nina, who every night pretend like they are sleeping. When they said everybody's asleep, they come out and start their night duty. They watch night duty, kissing, touching. Camera went to Toby and Sissy. Now when this one sleep, there's always a pillow in the middle of the boot of him. Somehow she took his hand now and went and touched Sissy. After like 40 seconds to 1 minute, I don't know what happened. He took his hand back and he slept. Princess, that one just a cock blocker. She doesn't have a bed. Princess went to sleep with Anto and Lulu on the same bed yesterday. I'm like, what's wrong with you? You behave yourself. And she has squeezed those ones together. Lulu held his Anto one corner. She slept like this. Anika slept alone. Angel slept alone. Ifo, you know. And that's it. So that's it for, what's it called? Episode day 8 in the Big Brother house. The battle line is drawn. The game has started. You know, I can't wait to see how every day plays out. And let's see. I know Wahala will be the house, sure. There's gonna be trouble in the house. I don't know. I feel Teddy's going to show his real color. And that's what we are here for, you know. Like I always say, like show yourself, entertain us. And that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. See you guys tomorrow. Take care. I saw all your comments yesterday. I think I got the highest comments on my page yesterday. You guys are amazing. Thank you so much for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Don't forget to tell your friends to subscribe, to watch. See you guys. When I started this YouTube channel, I said I was going to update my page once every week. Right now, I'm addicted. I'm always looking forward to doing a video. So thank you guys for watching. And God bless you all.